Good morning, students. In today's video, we are going to discuss about human rights awareness. Human rights education has been defined by United Nations as training, dissemination, and information efforts aimed at building of a universal culture of human rights. It means United Nations wants that there should be an international culture which support human rights, in which training of human rights, dissemination of various information related to human rights should be provided to each and every individual through imparting knowledge and skills and the molding of attitudes, so that people should adapt an attitude that the rights of others are the duty of ours. So this kind of attitude could be developed only when there would be a culture which support human rights, and that is possible only through human rights education. So human rights literacy in India, first we are going to discuss about it. Human rights literacy status, whatever we have achieved in our country, is as follows. National Action Plan for Human Rights Education, adopted by the Government of India, is focused on promotion and awareness of human rights to all sections of the society. Whatever action plan related to human rights education has been taken by government is completely focused on promoting the awareness of human rights in all types, all sections, all the segments of the society. Then the specific target groups have been identified for dissemination of education, such as schools, colleges and university. Obviously, these are the first centers from where this kind of education can be spread, because this is the place where people come, where the children come. So these are the specific target groups where the dissemination of education has been aimed on. Government officials, armed forces, prison officials and law officers are also sensitized through education to the protection of human rights, because these are the people who are going to implement human rights, who are going to make sure that human rights are not violated. So it is very much necessary that these people should be trained, these people should be sensitized about the protection of human rights. That is how important it is to protect the human rights of others. Then the Ministry of Home Affairs has also taken various steps to spread human right education by introducing various human right courses as a part of training for the BSF, Border Security Force, and CRPF, that is Central Reserve Police Force. So Ministry of Home Affairs has also taken certain steps by which they have introduced human rights as a course in the training which has been given to BSF and CRPF, so that they should also know that what are various human rights and what are what is the role play they have to play in the protection of human rights of others. Such courses have also been introduced as a part of training at the National Police Academy, police training colleges by the Government of India, so that they can also be sensitized about the human rights. Then major responsibility for human rights education has been given in hands of NHRC, that is National Human Rights Commission. About NHRC we have discussed in one of the previous videos. So they have been given this major responsibility that they should spread awareness of human rights among the masses. Now, role of NHRC in human rights education, as we have said in previous slide, that the major responsibility lies with NHRC. In the section 12H of NHRC, it has been said, it mandates the commission to take responsibility to spread human rights literacy among various sections of society and promote awareness of the safeguards available for the protection of these rights through publication, the media, seminars and other available means. So it is the responsibility of this commission, that is NHRC, that they have to spread human right literacy among all sections of the society. Also, they must tell them that what are the safeguards which are available to everyone for protection of their rights, and this kind of information can be given to them through various publication, through various medias or seminars or by any other means. Then the section 12 part G says, responsibility to undertake and promote research in the field of human rights. NHRC has major responsibility to promote various kind of researches, to undertake various kind of researches in the fields of human rights, so that they can find out what kind of trends are there, in our country related to the human right protection, or what are the problems people face while protecting their human rights, or what are the major causes which create violation of human rights. So all this is the responsibility of NHRC. Then section 12I says it is the responsibility of NHRC to encourage the efforts of non-governmental organizations. Various NGOs are also working in this area. So NHRC will support them. NHRC will encourage their efforts and institutions working in the field of human rights. Now, the threefold strategy of NHRC. NHRC asked for support of political parties represented in parliament or the state legislatures and suggested for making specific institutions at all levels. Right. So NHRC asked the government, whether at the center or the state, at the state level, that they must establish certain institutions at all levels, not only on central as well as at state level as well as at district level, or at all these levels there should be certain institutions which would help in promoting the human rights, monitoring the functioning, and remain in liaison with the commission. And they should, means those institutions which are opened at different levels, must be in contact with NHRC, and they should communicate with them, they should cooperate with them, and by this they can establish human rights at all levels in the country. Then NHRC contacted the chief ministers of all states with an idea to sensitize and train public servants in human rights matter, because public servants are the people who are going to ensure that the human rights are given to them. But many a times it has been noted that they are the people who themselves violate the rights of others. So NHRC contacted various CMs of different states, and they asked them to provide certain training to sensitize the public servants, the public or administrative people, so that they should know the importance of human rights and how they should handle in a better way. Then NHRC initiated a dialogue at central and state level with Human Resource Development Ministry, NCRT, and competent educational authorities respectively, to pursue the matter of human rights education at all levels of schools. Because education can only provided if starting from the school level, the children should know from the very beginning that what are the fundamental rights, how these rights have been given to them, and what is the importance of these rights. Then on later stages, various laws could be taught to them. So this by this they can make them know about various safeguards available to us in our country. Then commission also contacted vice chancellors of universities and deans of law faculties, asked them to find out the best possible way to introduce human rights as a subject at various university levels, right? So that we can very well see that at various universities, this subject has been accepted as a course in various streams, whether it is management or engineering or any other technical subject or humanities. Everywhere human rights has been taught, so that everyone should know about the safeguards which are available to us under human rights. So this is how NHRC work through these three strategies. Now, human rights education in school. During year 1994-95, series of meetings were conducted with the NCRT and Department of Education in Ministry of Human Resource Development. These meetings were focused on 4 points. What were those 4 points? First is review of existing textbook, so that to find out the portions that were harmful to human rights and then delete them. So that there should not be such a content in any of the book which itself condemned the human rights. Also to replace such portion with material that shows a sensitivity toward human rights. Instead, it should be replaced by such a content that shows that human rights have been supported or have been promoted from the very old ages, right? Then publication of a source book on human rights in collaboration with NCRT. This was the second step. Then preparation of module for teacher training, so that to prepare teachers for teaching human rights at various level. First, teachers should be trained so that they can obviously teach the students well. Then organizing workshop for non-governmental organizations, civil society to gain their support. This was the fourth step, so that various workshops could be organized for NGOs so that their support could be taken by them. It announced 10 December as Human Rights Day. We all know that on 10 December, UDHR was passed, so it is celebrated as International Human Rights Day in all schools across country every year. It published a handbook, Discrimination Based on Sex, Caste, Religion and Disability, for sensitizing teachers so that they should not discriminate anybody on any of these bases. Remaining parts we'll discuss in next class.